He is
George Legg. George is an old-time Fayette Counter, or Fayette Countyan, I guess we call him an old-time Fayette Countyan. George Legg was a friend of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. A lot of you probably have heard of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. Probably a lot of you haven't heard of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. But Fitzy Fitzpatrick was a native of Fayette County. He lived in Oak Hill, and he was a great boxer, or at least we think he was a great boxer. And that's why we're making this recording, so as some other folks can remember Fitzy Fitzpatrick, the almost heavyweight champion of the world. Fitzy Fitzpatrick, as we said earlier, was a Fayette Countyan. He was raised in and around Oak Hill. He attended Romney, which was a school for the blind and I guess the deaf and the blind, right? He was a great athlete at Romney. He made all-state football at Romney High School. Now, where he got into boxing, I don't know, but George sort of followed Fitzy Fitzpatrick's career as he came into his prime in the 40s. And what today, we're going to look at some pictures of Fitzy Fitzpatrick when he was out on the West Coast and some of the boxers that he's boxed. But before we get into the pictures, George, talk a moment about Fitzy, what you knew about Fitzy when you first met Fitzy and up until he started his boxing career.
Well, I met Fitzy in 1935 in Scarborough. And Fitzy, then we used to fight in 38 and 39 over to old Raleigh Rink at Beckley on the same card.
Now, this is amateur boxing.
Yeah, this was amateur. Mm-hmm. Then the war interrupted a lot of us guys. We had to go, but Fitzy, he couldn't get through the physical. Then he turned pro and made a great professional fight.
Now, about what year did Fitzy turn pro and start boxing professionally?
Fitzy Fitzpatrick turned pro in 1941. He was around 18 years old. And I imagine Fitzy had probably 100 professional fights.
Fitzy Fitzpatrick also, did he get into Golden Gloves? Did he box through the Golden Gloves, or did he box in the Olympics? This was asked.
No, he wasn't in the Olympics, Shirley. But he wasn't a great amateur fighter, really, because maybe he wasn't. He was a young man too, but he wasn't a great amateur fighter. But when he turned pro, he got hungry, and he become number one contender for the light heavyweight championship of the world.
That's the light heavyweight championship.
Yeah,
light. Remember what year that was, or approximately?
That was in 1946, 47. And he was also, around that time, was a number five contender for the heavyweight championship of the world.
Now, didn't Fitzy hold for, at one time, some sort of a record for the most knockouts in the first round?
Well, Shirley, I don't know about the record, but I do know Fitzy had 28 one-round knockouts.
That isn't a record. It's a good record in itself.
It's great. It probably wasn't straight now, but he had around 28 one-round knockouts.
I don't know what George Foreman has today, but I'm going to check that just to check it out. More about Fitzy and his boxing career before we look at the pictures. Light heavyweight contender, What year did he box Ezra Charles, which was the big one?
He fought Ezra Charles in around June of 47, Cincinnati Garden. He had Charles down in the second round, and Fitz at that time I always thought was going down. He was going over the hump. And he had scar tissue, Shirley, and Charles was a great fighter. And he had Fitzy's eyes bleeding. But when he knocked Charles down, he was like the Jack Dempsey and the Gene Tooney fight. He was standing over him. And they wouldn't start counting. He went to the neutral corner, which lost several seconds. They said if he would have went to neutral corner, that he would have knocked Ezra Charles out.
Then when he went to a corner, he didn't go to a neutral corner. He went toward his own corner, then had to be directed again to the neutral corner.
Yeah, and that wastes a lot of time, Shirley. I still say to this day that saved every child from being knocked out. Ezra was a great fighter. He later became the heavyweight champion of the world. Now, he fought Charles twice. The first fight was in Cincinnati Garden, and he fought Charles in Cleveland.
That's when he cut him. He cut him up.
Yeah, he was cut in both fights, but the second fight, we got to be honest about it, Shirley. He shouldn't have been in the same ring the second fight. He stopped Pitsy in both fights in the fifth round.
Who were some of the other great fighters, George, that Fitzy Fitzpatrick fought? Not only as a heavyweight, but as a light heavyweight, or a middleweight if he fought any middleweight fight.
Well, he fought as a light heavyweight. He fought Leonard Morrow and Bobby Zander. This was out in the West Coast. And he beat them guys. He fought, but the light heavyweight champion of the world, it seemed like he never could get Fitzy couldn't get a shot at the title. No doubt in my mind, he could have been the light heavyweight champion of the world. And then what happened, Shirley, them days, 176 pound, you're light heavy, but over 176, you're heavyweight.
Mm-hmm.
If you weighed 176 and a half, you fought a 300 pounder. There wasn't no cruiserweight in them days. Well, Fitzy had to go, and there's more money in that heavyweight in them days than there was light heavy. So Fitzy had to start fighting the big guys. They had a tough guy, Pat Valentino from California, was 240, 6'6", and Fitzy, what, 180 pound at that time.
This is some of the guys that fought Joe Louis,
didn't he? Yeah. He fought a lot of guys that fought Joe Louis, but Pat Valentino, he stopped Pat Valentino in the eighth round, and it took Ezra Charles in a title fight to stop. It took him 13 rounds to stop. And Fitzy fought Lee Savoie and stopped Lee Savoie quicker than Joe Louis stopped him. Joe Louis stopped Lee Savoie by 6. And Fitzy got him in, I think, 4 or 5. He was a terrific, hardest right hander in the game.
Can you remember how many fights Fitzy fought altogether? Do you know?
Not exactly, and I don't think Fitzy would know either. You know, it's been a long time, but I'd say Fitzy had from at least 100 professional fights. In the light heavy, in the heavyweight, in the middleweight. See, he started as a middleweight. And he was a sturdy guy, 5'11", and when he got out, it was hard for him to stay down to 176 pounds. And when he started to fight Bob Foxworth, a lot of those guys was contenders. And Fitzy was a big light heavy and a small heavyweight.
Mm-hmm.
But he fought some of the greatest guys in the game.
Back during the 40s, we didn't have television, and I can remember I was just a boy and a young boy, maybe 41, 42, 43. I was born in 33, so this may be 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 years old as Fitzy's career expanded into the 40s. But I can remember he was the Cinderella of Fayette County, of West Virginia, really. You could go into the old pool room, the smokehouse, Clay Garvin. Up on the wall was Fitzy Fitzpatrick's, all of his fight pictures. But everybody was around that radio when Fitzy Fitzpatrick fought in that Cincinnati Garden that you was talking about. But he was well followed by Fayette Countyans in West Virginia.
Well, when he fought Ezra Charles in Cincinnati, there was a train left Thurman. Old Judge Dillon was a lawyer over there, and Dick McCutcheon rented a whole coach. And old Dick was a great guy. He just loaded that thing up his expense and took him a lot of that fight. And there was a lot of people there that knew Fitzy and followed Fitzy and his fights. Now, Clay Garvin was a great man. And Clay used to follow Fitzy on the West Coast.
Mm-hmm.
He seen Fitzy fight. Watson Jones was another terrific fighter. He fought Watson 3 times. Fitzy beat Watson twice, and he beat Fitzy once. He'd fight anybody.
You know Fitzy's one-loss record? Do you remember it?
Well, see, Fitzy...
Well, you know his lost record. You know he fought around 100 fights.
Yeah, well, what happened, see, Fitzy wouldn't be hurt, Shirley, in his later years, and he TKO. He wouldn't be hurt, could still go. But he'd be bleeding. He had scar tissues bad, and sometimes he'd rip his eyes, and it'd take sometime maybe 20, 25 stitches, sew his eyes up. Mm-hmm. So a lot of time when you're bleeding, like you're not hurt, but you're bleeding, and you could have your eyes, you lose an eye, and maybe if they hadn't stopped some of them fights, Fitzy would have been blind today. Now, Fitzy's mind today, he's hard hearing, but his mind is great. He can, now a lot of fights I can ask him about, but he can, I know more about Fitzy now than he does himself. But Fitzy was the greatest fighter ever come out of West Virginia.
Tell you what you and I will do, we'll add these pictures to this video, and maybe one day next week, we'll take an evening and we'll take this camera and we'll go over and try to maybe talk a few minutes and get Fitzy on camera and just to reiterate maybe a few things that he can remember.
Well, Fitzy's in Chicago.
Boy, he's in Chicago.
His girl, his daughter come about 8 months ago, took him back, and Fitzy weighed around 320 and he's supposed to be my size, really. But he was...
Who were some of Fitzy's old buddies here in Fayette County, George?
Oh, Fitzy... I tell you,
besides you,
Fitzy, Clay Garmer was a great buddy of Fitzy, and Dick McCutcheon and the Wallaces, and Fitzy had a lot of friends, and see a lot of guys with knew Fitzy that he didn't know them. That's the way you are when you're in the spotlight.
Mm-hmm.
See, just like you, those guys know you, you don't know them. See, that's right.
That's true.
But Fitzy was well thought of, and he was. To my knowledge, he was the hardest trainer ever was. He loved to train, and Fitzy never big time.
He had a brother, too. Hayes, wasn't Hayes a pretty good fighter in his own right?
Hayes was a great fighter. He was a fighter about 140 pounds, and he could have made it. And now, he lost a brother in World War II in Saipan. Johnny Fitzpatrick, he was a middleweight champion in 2nd Marine Division.
And all these boys were raised in and around Scarborough and Carlisle, West Virginia, which is approximately a mile or 2 miles outside the city limits of Oak Hill, West Virginia. Who, what I'm saying, who, we're talking about Fitzy, is, who were some of the other old buddies around that you grew up with? Did you grow up here with Fitzy in this area?
Yeah,
who were some of the schoolboys that boxed around? You talk about boxing in the old Raleigh Armory. Who were some of the other early boxers from around here that boxed?
Clarence Rogers, which is a cousin of mine. Clarence was a great fighter. He wasn't the best fighter, but he was the meanest fighter. Clarence Rogers and Freddie Ferry, Glenn Jean, and John Henry Lawson. Masco Bentley and Pete Dixon and Cooper White was a great fighter. Cotton White was a great boxer.
Cotton was from over in Raleigh County, right?
Yeah, those boys from over in Raleigh, see. But Fitzy, he couldn't second you too good. Fitzy wanted you to knock everybody out.
Like he knocked everybody out.
Yeah, but
out.
You don't do that, see. But Fitzy, I've been with him around when he's had fighters, amateur fighters, since I've been back here. And Fitzy would disgust it and just walk off and let the number two second take over. So Fitzy wanted to boom him, knock him out, get up.
Okay, and I'm talking with George Legg, a friend of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. Fitzy Fitzpatrick, one of the greatest fighters to ever come out of Fayette County and West Virginia. And next we're going to look at some of the career in pictures of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. Hilton J. Fitzy Fitzpatrick, born July 14, 1927 at Hilltop, West Virginia. Let's take a look now at some of the fighters that Fitzy Fitzpatrick fought during his career. And George, that gentleman I think you mentioned earlier when we was talking about some of the fights that Fitzy had.
That is Pat Valentino. He was a great heavyweight there in California. And later on he became a contender and fought Ezra Chaw for a heavyweight title. Now, Fitzy stopped him in the eighth and it took Ezra Charles 13 rounds, stopped Pat.
Okay, this next gentleman. We're going to switch pictures here, so we'll just sort of have to line up pictures as we go. Okay?
That's one of his sparring partners there. Fitz had never fought him. They was in the same gym, the training together there for a fight. He never fought that guy, and he just worked out with him.
Okay, here's one, a little burn place on it.
That's Bobby Zander. He fought in California, and Bobby was a good fighter, but Fitzy beat him, and Fitzy stopped him.
Okay, here we go.
This is another one of his boys in his same camp, but another sparring partner for Fitzy. I don't recall this fighter here, but Fitz has stopped him in five rounds.
Now, this is a biggie here, right?
Yeah, this is when he fought...
Okay, we had a little accident there. He fell on the floor, but we'll get it. This is Ezra Charles' fight, right?
Yeah, that's the first fight with Ezra Charles. They fought in Cincinnati Gardens in 1947 in around June, and he had Charles down in the second, had him beat, but he wouldn't go to a neutral corner, and he got a little time there, Charles did. So Charles stopped him in the fifth on a TKO.
Now, Fitzy was hard of hearing, and they said, what, 7, 8, maybe as much as 10 seconds elapsed between him, by him standing over the fighter, being knocked down, Ezra Charles, and then going to not a neutral corner, but toward his own corner. And before he got oriented, 8, 10 seconds had elapsed.
That's right. That was in Ezra Charles' favor there. I believe if this hadn't happened, Fitzy would have stopped Charles there.
Okay, now this is another shot of the knockdown of Ezra Charles.
Right? Yes.
Now, was this the same knockdown, just at a different angle, or another knockdown in it?
I think this happened in the second fight. They fought in Cleveland. The second fight. Now, this guy on the left is Lisa Vold. He was a leading contender. He fought Joe Louis for the title. Joe Louis stopped him in 6. And Fitzy fought him and stopped him, I think, in about 4 rounds.
Okay, here's a guy you was telling me about earlier. I don't know who he was, but he's a movie star or married a movie star or something.
Yes, this is a great football player to play for the Rams, L.A. Rams. His name was Bob Waterfield. He got in a movie, and he was married to Jane Russell one time, and he was a great fan for Fitz, and they was great friends.
Jane Russell, she was the one that played the outlaw in the movie, what they call
yes.
It, the outlaw?
Yes, Waterfield, they was married at one time, and they was great friends of Fitzpatrick.
Yeah, I remember that film was obscene back there in 1940. You remember that? Remember
oh,
that,
yeah.
George? My mother wouldn't let me go see that movie. Well, she wouldn't let me go see Jane Russell because she's had too big of boobs. Okay, this guy, there's a good shot of Fitzy, and is that a commissioner or something of boxing?
No, that's a matchmaker there, but this was after a fight. You could tell by looking at Fitzy, his eyes a little swollen, but this was after he fought a heavyweight fight.
Okay, let's pick up some pictures here of Fitzy and some of the friends. Maybe you know these, George, maybe you don't.
This was a group, I think, after a fight in a bar, I think, in Newport, Kentucky. That's close to Cincinnati. A lot of Fitzy's followers. Fitzy's on that picture. You can locate him there.
Okay, another shot of Fitzy, and below it, superimposed over, is probably a newspaper clipping. It says, Fitzy Fitzpatrick scored his second KO in as many weeks when he knocked out Lou Burdett in 1 round. He stopped Jack McCahill in 2 at Cleveland. Fitzy is in the same stable of Tommy Mulgrew's with Bobby Richardson, Jimmy Trusso, Jimmy Mandel, and Bobby McQuillan. Now, the old-timers, they would remember who some of those old fighters were, right? Okay, here's a shot, I guess, of his son.
Yeah, that was his young son in Fitz's early career, and he, this was on his dude ranch in California. Fitzy enjoyed it. He was wanting to be a rodeo man, but his managers wouldn't let him because he loved the horses, and he probably could have made a rodeo star.
Well, someone said that Fitzy at one time owned a huge ranch out in Southern California or Nevada or somewhere. Is that true, George?
California. He owned a dude ranch out there.
Okay, let's pick up another. Here is Fitzy probably after a fight getting a shower, and That's a good close-up to show you that he was one hawk of a man, really.
He was a fine-looking boy to be a fighter, and he was a well-built man, and he loved to train harder and better than anybody I ever seen.
Okay, if we can stop the camera now, we'll get over and get a few of these smaller prints and continue with this pictorial interview of Hilton Fitzy Fitzpatrick, light heavyweight boxer. Okay, more pictures of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. And the gentleman on the right is Dude Fitzpatrick, right, George? And that's the father of Fitzy Fitzpatrick. Some other members of Fitzy's family, this young lady?
That's Fitzy's daughter there, and I think she's in Chicago now.
Know her name?
No, I don't.
On the back, Kale?
Terry.
Terry Fitzpatrick. And I presume that's either his son... he had three children.
Yeah, that's one of Fitzy's little children there.
Here's a picture of Fitzy when he was at Romney, the football team, and he made All-State. I suppose that was sometime in the 30s, late 30s. And a lot of people have said from time to time, like we say, we don't know what year this is, but it had to be about 37, 38, 39, maybe in 1940. Some people said, was Fitzy Fitzpatrick connected with the Mafia? This is some of his buddies in Cleveland. You know those, George?
Well, he had two managers. One of them was Sparky Rudolph, and the other was Mickey Kelcher. Now, Sparky was the crook, as you call it, the Mafia or whatever. But Mickey was a pretty fair shooter, and that's the reason Fitzy woke up really broke in his later years.
You mentioned earlier in that Ezra Charles fight, his purse was something like how much?
In 47 and when he fought Charles in the Cincinnati Gardens, he got 40 grand. That was in 1947.
Which of that guy got three times 40, huh?
Yeah, in the second fight he fought him in Cleveland, he got 32,000, which in 1947, that was good boxing money.
It's like $500,000 now.
Right.
And there again, as we close out this interview, Fitzy Hilton Fitzy Fitzpatrick. And that knockdown of Ezra Charles, who went on to win the world heavyweight champion, knocked out Joe Louis, knocked out Joe Walcott once too, didn't he, George?
Yeah, he beat Walcott, and Walcott beat him, but Charles became heavyweight champion. He was a great fighter.
If anyone brings up boxing and says, I wonder if any great boxers ever came out of West Virginia, you can say, yeah, I know one. It was Hilton Fitzy Fitzpatrick, born 1927 at Hilltop, Fayette County, West Virginia, light heavyweight and heavyweight. At one time, the fifth contender for the light heavyweight, and fought Ezra Charles, who went on to win the heavyweight championship of the world. This interview has been with Mr. George Legg, old-time friend and family friend of Fitzy Fitzpatrick, who grew up with him, followed his career, boxed with him, and knew him as a friend. My name, Shirley Love.